Any tips for moving across the country with an anxious dog?
So we'll cover that, but let's also cover what an anxious dog is and some travel tips in general and things you can do at home and during your trip to make it more comfortable for your dog and easier to travel with. So understanding your anxious dog, get down to what is causing your dog to be anxious. So because it can stem from a health issue, it can come from a traumatic experience. First thing I'd encourage everybody to do is have a professional training company like Got Sit Dog Training or a professional trainer come out and do an evaluation, do an assessment, and give you an idea of what you're working with. From there, you can then take the steps to acclimate your dog to get ready to travel. Next, we'll cover things you can do during your travel to make it more comfortable for your dog and things you can do at home to prep to make your dog more comfortable for the travel. All right, when you're gonna do an exercise to help your dog become more acclimated to the process, everything starts in the house. So even moving out the front door can set the tone to a balanced or an unbalanced training session. So moving through your front door alone has to be in a calm, submissive state. It has to be something that you're exercising every bit of patience you have, but you're trying to induce a calm mood. So everything you do subsequent to moving out the front door is going to be calm, 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 calm. So we move out the front door in a calm, submissive state. I'll go so far as to even have my dog in a heel, moving towards the car, and I'm gonna be watching and observing my dog's behavior. So as we get near the car, if I see any anxious behavior, I'm going to do what's necessary to redirect my dog's energy into that calm state, whether it be through tricks, engaging in obedience skills, etc. But as I reach for the car door, it escalates again. I'm gonna create a calm state. I don't move forward pressuring my dog into the next bit of the exercise unless my dog is actually in a calm state. So once I start seeing what is triggering or where are we getting triggered, I can start working with those in baby steps. It can be as simple as touching it, putting a paw up on the edge of the car and then moving away from it, rewarding your dog for touching the car, create a calm environment again, calm mood, move back towards the car. Our goal is to get the dog into the car and calm. So if we get into the car, dog starts to get a little excited. It might even be excitement, but excitement can turn to anxious behavior as you travel. So wait till the dog be calm, then I shut the door. Then it goes from shutting the door to simple tasks of even moving the car in and out of the driveway, getting back out of the car. It takes time, but if we're patient, our dog's gonna sense our calm mood. They're going to emulate our mood and our energy. So outside of doing the exercises to get the dog acclimated to the vehicle and or the motion of the vehicle moving, et cetera, doing small trips, whether it be to the market, around the block, going to church, turn it into longer trips. Sometimes we have to step back and say, is this extra step we can do to make our dog more comfortable? And that is where we introduce a kennel. So some dogs are more calm outside of a kennel, some dogs more calm inside of a kennel. Aside from which one may or may not work better, if a dog is rambunctious, tends to circulate the car, jump into your lap, that's a safety issue, in which case I 100% recommend either a harness of sorts or a kennel situation. But we've now done the exercises and baby steps to get our dog acclimated to the car. We now want to now add the kennel into the car and get them acclimated to that. If the dog has never been in a kennel, and we go back inside the house and we get our dog in baby steps, comfortable going in and out of the kennel and being left in there with the door shut for 30 seconds, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, etc. But keeping a dog from moving around and pacing essentially is sometimes that added step to keeping the dog in a calm, submissive state while traveling. Now let's get on the road. Whether we're going cross country or we're going for a couple hour trip and it's our first big move, make frequent stops. This needs to be a comfortable and relaxing situation if we're gonna repeat it especially. So my thing is to find the first rest stop, exit the car calmly, get the dog engaged in some basic obedience so they're paying attention to you. Keep them from sniffing and getting distracted because that can also put them in a more anxious state. Move them to a potty area, let them potty, reward them for potty, do a little bit of mental stimulation, some tricks, basic obedience. But whatever you're doing, try to take it from any excited reward back down to a calm set of rewards as you get closer to the car. Give them plenty to drink, making sure that you're making your frequent stops to let the dog go potty. But they need water to feel balanced, not dehydrated. So getting back into the car, it's the same thing. It's got to be something super calm, getting into the car, setting the tone, leading with your energy so the dog emulates again a calm, submissive state. We're about to travel again. So, and then, you know, 20, 30 miles, watch your dog's behavior. If your dog's asleep, keep going. If your dog is panting, stop.